All right, guys, so an update. As you saw in a previous video, this is the car that was white that I was talking about that we had just disassembled that was gonna be put on a rotisserie and all that. Well, my brother just finished painting it. Well, not just finished painting it, but it is ready to go to the shop to start the assembly process, but I'm gonna give you guys a little breakdown. So this car, if you remember, used to be white. The customer wanted a blue color. We finalized on a Le Mans blue type. So what we did is we started off with the, you know, I'm sure you guys have seen it from like the E92 M3s. They came with like a Le Mans blue. So we took that color, altered it a little bit to the customer's liking. And my brother went ahead and did a full color conversion, which means interior, engine bay, jams, everything. I'll walk you guys through it. This car also got a full undercarriage restoration. So we are gonna take it back to the shop and start the assembly process. You know, here's some of the body parts and whatnot, but you know, just wanted to give you guys a quick glimpse. It's a little dusty, a little dirty right now since it's been out here about a day, but we're gonna start assembling this thing and we're gonna go pretty hard on this thing and get this thing up and running pretty fast. Quick update on the Le Mans Blue E30 M3 we're doing. As you know, or as I stated before, we're gonna be doing S54. There's a full nut and bolt restoration, resto mod, rebuilding a car, whatever you guys wanna call it. The guys are assembling rear suspension right now. Adam, as you can see, is doing some rear brake lines. But these, Adam, I don't think we have to put
what?
These lines. Cause do those shits come with their own? They do, right? All right, it's all good. All right, so I have Adam doing some brake line work right now. They already put the full rear suspension. Everything's powder coated, ground control coilovers. Diane was doing the sway bar. Fuel tank is in, fuel lines, fuel filter. The EVAP system's all done. We're basically gonna be working from the rear forward, which is typically how we do stuff because there's not very much to the front end of these cars. But as you can see, you know, we have the subframe, trailing arm, AKG bushings on all of them, new wheel bearings, parking brakes, parking shoes are on, all the hardware's on. We're missing the hubs. We're gonna put on the hubs. This car's gonna get the IE big brake kit, 6-piston front, 4-piston rear. And whoever has installed those knows that you gotta cut the shield off. So we've already pre-cut these, sent them out to powder coating. The calipers, everything's already, you know, painted, powder coated from IE. So we'll get that buttoned up shortly and I'll just show you the rest. Like I said, the EVAP system's all done. We're missing the fuel filler hose, but everything's there. Fuel tank cleaned up, brake lines, EVAP lines. The guys threw on the front subframe, but like I said, the rear is most important because the front, it's a subframe, control arms, struts, spindles. So we're gonna be moving forward. Once we make this a rolling chassis, we're gonna install the body harness back in it. While the guys are working in team with the body harness, the sunroof, we're gonna assemble the engine bay, get everything back on the engine bay that needs to be in there before the motor gets dropped in. So you'll see us dropping in the motor and all that afterwards, trans, diff, drive shaft, and all that good stuff. I got my drive shafts back for the swaps. And those are for S54 with a 6-speed, which is the correct way of doing it because a lot of people use the automatic drive shaft, which is not the way you want to be doing it because you're left with very little engagement on the spline. So if you're doing a swap, make sure you get a custom drive shaft made. But we will follow back up on this with you guys and show you guys the progress. Not E30 stuff in here, so I got a couple of X braces, but I got all the trailing arms, the dust shield, subframes are in the bottom, and yeah, it's my job to kind of go through it, make sure that everything was done correctly, and make sure that everything is here. Sometimes some stuff gets lost or misplaced, so I'll show you guys later on what all this entailed, but it's like I said, it's in this crate was about 6 cars worth of suspension components, trailing arm subframes, sway bars, brackets, tabs, you name it, we took it. We got a powder coat it cleaned up because these are gonna be for these 30 M3s that we're restoring. And I will also show you guys all the hardware and everything that goes into restoring these cars. So hopefully you guys like that episode. All right, quick update on Gumby. The car is theoretically a running, driving car. All the drivetrain's done. Having the guys, Adam and Daniel, were installing sound system, head unit, speakers, dashboard, the door panels. Nothing really crazy going on in the interior of this car. It's pretty much all OEM plus. Get it as clean as possible, tan interior. Gonna be assembling that, then we're gonna put the convertible frame in there and then have our buddy George go ahead and do the top. After that, we'll get the body panels on. The only reason why they're not on yet is because we're waiting for a few AC components. Once those come in, we'll put the body panels back on there. You'll see us put the glass. And finally, we're just gonna bleed the brakes and get the AC charged up and start driving this thing around. And we'll do its own little episode, shooting it and breaking everything down for you guys as to how it got done, why it got done, and all that good stuff. So enjoy, like, subscribe if you want to see more.